What is going on, you guys? My name is Josh, also known as Hairytornado, and my full-time job is selling things on eBay and making YouTube videos about it. There's some ladies walking over there, so they are definitely staring at me. But we had a good weekend on eBay. I took some time off from YouTube, didn't make any videos in the last 3 or 4 days, but we still had some really good sales. We got 24 things going out from eBay over the weekend, and I also have 3 or 4 things that I sold directly to viewers. So 27 or 28 things going out today. Let's get to work. First thing going out today is a pair of Nike Air Jordans. These were a kid's size. They're right here, if I can find them. They're like a kid's size, but I talked about them when I listed them in a live listing show with Joey and Drew the other night. And a couple of you guys said that if they're a kid's size, you can also list them as a women's. So my title, I listed these as Nike Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG Black Gold 6Y Women's 7.5. With Nike Air Jordans, the women's size is always 1.5 bigger than the kids. And these are more likely to sell for a higher amount listed as a women's shoe than a kid's shoe. So I listed them as a kid's size, and in the description I just put, you know, these also fit as a women's size 7.5. And I don't know if the buyer bought them for a kid or a woman, because the buyer was a man. But either way, they sold for $65 free shipping. Pretty lightweight. They're probably going to cost about $8-9 to ship out. And I got these at Goodwill. Paid $6.50 for these. Actually, no, these were a kid size, so these were only $4.50. So really good flip, $4.50 into $65 free ship. The next item is up here in the A bin, and it is some J. Crew shirts. A6 right here. I got these a long time ago. I think I got them at Goodwill. I mean, I've had them listed for over a year. I want to say I paid $1.50 each because they're like really thin t-shirt material, and it's a lot of two. They're both J. Crew, both the exact same size. That was a picture, extra, extra small. I think with J. Crew, you want to shoot for maybe the bigger sizes, like large and above. There's just extra, extra small is just such a small market. There's an extra, extra small market for extra, extra small people. So these, somebody sent me an offer of $10 plus shipping on there, and I went ahead and accepted it. So still making a little bit of money, but just not a very good pickup. Again, J. Crew is decent if you can get it for the right price, but it's got to be the right size as well. This next item sold to a viewer named Garrett from Ware's Cave, Virginia, and it should be down here in the file drawer. At least that's where I said I was going to put it. Oh, wait, no, I didn't. It should be over here on the ground because I never put them up. It's some more of these Shrek Build and Grow kits. This is the dragon one. I had like the Shrek onion carriage before, and those sold out. Then I found these in my death pile over there the other day. I got these at the Goodwill bins, probably about 25 cents a piece, and this sold for $9.99 free shipping. So Garrett, thanks so much, man. I appreciate the support. Next item going out is a pair of shoes. It's a pair of like brown Cabela's right here. Now, I didn't really know Cabela's made shoes, but they do. I found these at Goodwill a couple months ago, maybe 3 months ago, and they're in excellent condition. Vibram soles. Just a really solid looking pair of shoes. Shout out Cabela's for making good looking shoes. These did, like I said, they did sit for about 3 months listed, but they eventually sold for $45 free shipping. I got these at Goodwill for $6.50. Next item is going out to a viewer named Jocelyn Milne, I think, M-I-L-N-E. She's from overseas somewhere because this item sold through the eBay Global Shipping Program, but it's over here in the S bin. So Jocelyn, thanks for your support. And she bought this little chameleon guy from me. I've had him listed for a while. I think I got him at the Goodwill bins for probably 25, 50 cents or so. And Jocelyn paid $11 free shipping through the Global Shipping Program. So she'll probably end up paying like $20 or $25 for this after all the import fees and taxes and stuff. So Jocelyn, thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it. Next item going out are these two lip gloss stick makeup things. These sold to a viewer named Anne from Mount Holly, North Carolina. Anne, thank you so much for those. She bought the 2-pack for $11.99 free shipping, and I'm about a dollar into both of these, about 50 cents a piece. I was going to sell them on Amazon, but it's just really complicated selling makeup on Amazon. So I'm just putting them up on eBay. I have two different shades, like I don't know, one's like 805 and one's 220, whatever that means. So Ann bought two of the 220s for $11.99 free shipping. They're gonna cost like $3 to ship out, got a dollar into it, so making like $5 or so. So Ann, thank you so much. This next item is in the Q bin over here, and it's this advanced teeth whitening stuff. I picked this up at Dream Deals, I think one of the first weeks, like the first or second week I went, paid $6 for this.
And it's sold to a viewer named
Alexis Sylvia from North Fort Myers, Florida. And she paid $24 free shipping for this. So Alexis, thank you so much for your support. Another pair of shoes going out. This is a pair of black Nikes. If I can find them somewhere. Oh, I think these are, yeah, Nike Zoom Windflows. I picked these up at, I don't remember if it was Salvation Army or Goodwill. I mean, that's where I get all my shoes, Salvation Army or Goodwill. If they were Goodwill, they were $6.50. Salvation Army, they were either $5.99 or $6.99. So let's be conservative and say $7 for this. And they sold for $47.99, free shipping. The next two items sold to a viewer named Matthew Glenn from Clinton, Maryland. Matthew has bought a few things for me in the past, so I definitely appreciate the continued support on the channel. He bought some headphones and some mechanic gloves. So let's go ahead and get those pulled. The headphones are in the R bin. They should be. This was a dream deal. Yeah, here's some. I got like five of these at Dream Deals, one of the first days they opened. I actually kept a pair for personal use, and I love these. They're kind of like fake Power Beats headphones, like the over-the-ear Beats headphones. Really, really awesome. And then the other one was in the mechanics gloves. Where were they? The mechanic gloves were in the T bin down here. Oh, I could see them right here. Mechanic gloves, HDD, Hand Landy. Also another Dream Deals find. I think I got this on like a $3 or $4 day. Not 100% sure, but he got the gloves and the Yenemy headphones for a total of $49 free shipping. Matt, again, thanks for the support, man. I really appreciate it. Big sale coming up from the E-Bin right here. This is that camera lens adapter that I picked up at Dream Deals like 2 weeks ago. I paid $6 plus tax for this, and it sold for $119.99 free shipping. Really great sale there. I knew this would sell eventually, but I didn't think it would sell so quickly. It was only listed for about a week or so, and I didn't even accept offers or anything. Just sold full asking price, $119.99 free shipping. Next item sold to a viewer named Howard Hastings from Arizona, and it should be down here in the R bin. And it is some those thick winter gloves that I got at the Goodwill bins a couple weeks ago in my video. Really, really nice. They're like leather, like on the palms and fingers, and super insulated, waterproof. Probably paid maybe 75 cents for these, and they sold for $14 free shipping. Really nice viewer sale going out to Julie Stevens from California. She bought some Nike Shocks for me, and these were not a cheap pair of shoes at all. I found these at Goodwill a couple weeks ago, maybe like last week actually. Paid $6.50 for these. These are basically brand new, like very, very minimal wear. Julie saw them in the video, asked what size they were, and I told her, and then the next day she bought them. Full asking price, $69.99 free shipping. Julie, thank you so much. I really appreciate the support. Next item is in the W file, baby. Getting back in the file cabinet. The only thing in the W file is this Allen and Roth Mitchell robe hook. I think I got this at Salvation Army for like $1.99, and it sold for $15.99 free shipping. Next item is another viewer sale going out to Kenneth Thompson from Missouri, and it is some shoes. I think it's these L.L. Beans right here. Am I right? Yeah, those are the same ones. Kenneth bought these for $34 free shipping. I got these at the Goodwill bins. They don't have any insoles, but you can always add some third parties in there. These probably cost me about $2.50 or so. So Kenneth, thanks so much, man. I really appreciate the support. I sold some of my Support Your Friends hoodies. This first one down here sold to a viewer named Jamie Kale. I think I'm pronouncing that name right. And she is from Ontario, Canada. She goes by Thrift on Fire on YouTube and Instagram. So Jamie, thank you so much for your support on that one. And then a viewer named Alexa French from Ohio bought two of my Support Your Friends hoodies for a total of $108. These hoodies are crazy expensive, but I'm not really making a lot of money on them. I think I make like $6 or $7 on each hoodie, but it's just crazy that somebody's willing to spend over $100 on two hoodies. I'm assuming one is a large, one is an extra large, so maybe it's like her and her husband or something. So I definitely appreciate the support. Thank you so much for supporting me, and I don't know, it just blows me away when people buy stuff like this. I really, really appreciate it. Next item is down here in the G bin, and it's some of these Charbroil Meat Claws X-Men cosplay. Just kidding. I got these at Dream Deals on $1 day. I think I got five of them, you know, for a dollar each, and this one sold for $14.99 free shipping. So I listed these like one picture with a quantity of five, so one sold for $14.99 free shipping, and then I still have
I should still have four available for purchase. So I really like multi-quantity listings on Dollar Day and Fill-A-Bag Day. I get 10 of one thing and then just list it once with a quantity of 10, and it can sell throughout the year. You know, it may take a while to sell, but there's very, very minimal work to do on my part. So I love selling stuff like this for sure.
I'm super excited about this next sale. I don't know if it's up here or not, but I've had this thing listed for a long, long time. There it is. It's this little duck. I found him at Goodwill a long time ago, probably, I mean, over a year, maybe even like a year and a half ago. Original price was $27.75, and I think I got it at Goodwill for like $2.99. And at the original time I found it, I was looking up sold comps, and some similar, you know, models, I guess, of ducks were selling for $25 to $30 free shipping. So I thought it was a good deal. But this thing has been listed for over a year, and eventually somebody sent me an offer this past weekend of $10 plus shipping, and I went ahead and accepted that. Look at that cute little duck. He's so cute. But not a very good seller. Probably wouldn't buy that duck again. But make it some money, that's for sure. Next item, I believe, is over here, and it's two of these. I've got three of these TC1 workout gels left, and one buyer bought two of them and paid $27.99 each. So for the two, they were in $55.98 free shipping. I got these at Dream Deals for $6 each plus tax. So say like $12.30 into it and selling it for $55.98 free shipping. Even them together will probably go first class. If they're over 16 ounces, I'll just throw them in a padded flat rate envelope and they'll cost like $7.50 to ship out. So really good sale there. I thought these would sell a lot faster. I think these got pretty flooded in the market because I think a lot of these hit these Amazon bin stores at the same time, and maybe people had sold out. You know, people dropped the price to like $10 or $15 sold out, and then my listing was the only one left, I guess. I don't know why anybody else would pay $27.99. I think I sold one of these like 2 or 3 weeks ago for like $15 because somebody sent me an offer on it. But it just goes to show, if you can hold out for that price that you want for long enough, eventually it might sell. Sold two more of my Support Your Friends t-shirts. The first one sold to Carla Mueller from Florida. Carla, thank you so much for that. I really appreciate it. And the second one sold to Stephanie Harrison from Georgia. So Stephanie, thank you for your support as well. And the last eBay order of the weekend is another one of the teeth whitening things right here. Got in at Dream Deals for $6. And these sold for $24 free shipping to a viewer named Sereni or Sereni. I'm so sorry, I don't know how to pronounce your name. Sereni or Sereni Rodriguez from New York. So thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate that. And like I said, I had a few sales this weekend that went directly to viewers. The first one went to Richard Engelman, and he bought the Moana Pua plush, the little plush, the little pig that I found at the Goodwill bins a couple weeks ago. So Richard, thanks for your support there. He paid $16 free shipping for that. A viewer from up in Canada named Dennis Stokes bought this keyboard that I found last week at Dream Deals, the keyboard and mouse combo, the mechanical RGB gaming keyboard. He paid $40 free shipping for that. I didn't know he was in Canada when I told him the price, so hopefully it's not going to cost a ton to ship because it's like a $60 keyboard. But he was super nice. He's like, if you need more money, let me know, but I don't want to have to do that. So hopefully we can get it shipped out and not lose too much money on that. And then another viewer named Lewis Renteria bought this cord for me. I picked it up at Fill-A-Bag Day last week when I went to Dream Deals and got this whole bag of stuff, not the keyboard, but the whole bag of like craft supplies and stuff for $20. And I just grabbed this. It's like an anchor cord. It's a USB-C to HDMI. And he reached out on Instagram. It's like, hey, I saw the cord. Can I buy it from you? I was like, yeah, man. So he paid $8 free shipping for this. I have no idea what it's worth, but if he can use it, that's why I got it. I figured somebody could be able to use it. So that's going out to Lewis. Thanks, man.
So I have all my orders packed up and ready to go to the post office. But as always, I want to give you guys a full financial breakdown so you can see exactly how much profit I'm going to have in my pocket after all fees and expenses are accounted for. Now, I am going to exclude all of the print-on-demand items from today's synopsis. I had two t-shirts and three hoodies that sold. Generally, I'm going to make like $6 or $7 on the hoodies and about $5 or $6 on the t-shirt. So I'll factor that profit in at the end. But in terms of the numbers, I'm going to show you on my little cardboard cards here, the shirt and hoodie sales are not going to be included in that. So we had a total gross sales from this past weekend of $636, again, not including the print on demand stuff. After we take out our eBay fees on the eBay portions, because this was everything we sold on eBay, as well as those three things we sold directly to viewers, we're left with $565.29. Then we have to take out our total shipping costs, which for every item we sent out today was just $132.36. I think the most expensive thing to ship was that keyboard and mouse to that guy up in Canada, and that was only like $15 or so. The second most expensive thing we shipped out was a pair of Nike Shocks, and that was going from South Carolina, where I am, all the way to California, and those were like $14. Everything else was pretty cheap, either first class or a padded flat rate envelope. Next, we have to take out our total cost of goods for everything that sold in today's video. That was just $79.74. A really low cost of goods. Generally, with reselling, if you're getting stuff at thrift stores and yard sales and Amazon overstock stores, I rarely pay more than $7 for an item, $6 or $7. And most of my items probably have an average cost of goods of like $5 or less, you know? So that's a great thing about this business. The cost of goods is typically very low. So when we account for both of those, we are left with a net profit amount of $353.19. And we can also factor in about a $30 profit from those t-shirts and hoodies that I was talking about. So let's change this to $383.19 as like a total profit from this weekend of things we sold. And then I like to save 25% of this to pay my income taxes. So after we take out our income taxes, we are left with $287.39, an actual profit in my pocket, ready to be spent however I see fit. That's the beauty of being a business owner. You can make your own money and tell it what to do once it's yours. So not too bad for a nice little holiday weekend of eBay sales.
I think Mo's is outside. Oh, hey. Hey, little sunbather. You look like you're having a good day, getting all warm. Haley and I came out here yesterday on the holiday, and we raked up some leaves. We didn't pick them up, we just raked them up. I might get my brother-in-law out here to actually bag the leaves up. Raking is always easier than bagging, but I like it. The yard is looking nice. We got rid of all that wood. If you guys remember a couple videos ago when I put like my old shoe shelf, we cut it up and burned it in the pile yesterday. We just had a pretty productive day, and so look at Mo's. He's so cute. So I'm gonna hang out with Mo's in the yard for a couple minutes, just run him around, get some energy out, and then I'm gonna head to the post office. And I guess we'll go to at least one thrift store today to kind of round out the video. I'm here at my local Salvation Army. They've been open for like 2 hours, and usually if you're not here when they open, you don't really find a ton of good stuff. I did come last week at like 3:30, which they open at 12, so I was 3.5 hours after they opened, and I found really good stuff, like two brand new pairs of Brooks running shoes, like three HP toner cartridges that sell for like $50 a piece. So you can find some good stuff later on in the day, but typically you don't. So it's like 2 o'clock right now. They've been open about 2 hours or so. So we'll go in here and see if we can find anything good. So double decker. Got some catcher's mitt. Louisville Slugger catcher's mitt. For $3.99. It's a little worn, but I'll take a chance on that. It's a really cool pair of Nikes right here. I think these are LeBrons, but they're really bald on the bottoms, on the bottom heels. Cool colorway though. Some leopard print Brooks. A little ripped up on the side. Pretty bald on the bottom. Oh, wow. Dang. Those are trash. Oh, another pair like this. Look at these. Definitely grab those for $5.99. On this Rock Band drum set, Xbox 360. It's got this interesting pattern on the side. And then if you look at the pedal, it's the Beatles version. I usually pass on these because I don't like shipping them, but for $5.99, I'll take a chance on this. Looking up sold comps on the drums, there's one that sold right there for $75 free shipping, but no pedal. And the pedal by itself, I mean, some of it can sell for, I mean, that one, just the pedal sold for $30 plus $10 shipping. With the guitar, it sells for that one sold for $240 plus $60 shipping. Lots of soul comps just for the pedals. So I think I can probably get maybe $150 or something. Some Adidas cleats. These things look pristine. I don't know anything about these, but I can't say no to those for $5.99. Fila's not so much. For a Nike Zucker. Oh, those are too bald. Some Heelys. Kids Heelys. The dual wheels. Some. And those are bald. These Nike $6. I don't know. I think these will clean up pretty nice. Kids shoes for $6. Take a chance on those too. This really cool hat. I can get it off the little rack here. It's got the little dangly bobber in the front. It feels like a suede leather or something. Dorfman Pacific handmade headwear. Huh. All hats are, I don't know what they charge me for this. Probably like $2 or so. I'll take a chance on that. Got two sealed warm vanilla sugar from Bath & Body Works for $1.99 each. These could be good. Let's look them up. Okay, so warm sugar vanilla on eBay. There's one that sold for $16 free shipping. Another one sold for $8 plus shipping. That one sold for $7.50 plus shipping. And that's it. So, I mean, not a ton of money, but I think they're probably discontinued. Or if they're not yet, they will be eventually. So these are usually only go up in value. So I might sell one now and stick one in the death pile to list in a couple years when they go up in value some more. But still worth picking up for $2 a piece. This is probably one of the coolest things I've ever seen in here. It's an old vintage sled for $10. Like old. Old sled. That's crazy. It's missing some screws right there, but this would be like, if this was an antique store or something, this would be $150 probably. I'm definitely gonna grab that for $10. It's crazy. And a cool metal coat rack thing here too. I really like that. Very industrial. I don't know how much it is. It doesn't have a tag, but really cool. So I got the sled. There was a little bit of drama because I was standing in line to pay for the sled and this guy was like, that thing's already sold. And I was like, well, there's not a sold sticker on it. He's like, it says right there, sold. And he pointed at the sticker and I was like, that says sled, not sold. And he was like, well, dang, I wanted that thing. I thought it was sold. I didn't ask about it, blah, blah, blah. Like, I wanted it. I'm like, well, he should have read the fine print, I guess. That was a great trip to Salvation Army. Probably better than the last trip, which I thought was going to be impossible to beat. But that Rock Band, Beatles Rock Band drum set, again, should probably sell for like $130 plus shipping, maybe like $175 free shipping, because it is the Beatles theme. As long as it works, I do have an Xbox 360 on hand to test that, so I'll test it when I get home to make sure it all works. Like I said, usually I pass on those because I don't really want to ship big stuff like that, but with a $150 item or so, I think it'll be worth it. That sled's really awesome. I have no idea what it's worth, but definitely worth picking up for $10. That pair of Hokas that are in really good condition, those will probably sell for $50 or $60 pretty easily. I mean, just a ton of profit in today's haul. I think I spent, I don't know where my receipt is, but I spent like $44 on everything altogether. And I have no idea how much money I'll make, probably like over $300. Definitely a great thrifting trip to cap off a pretty great weekend of eBay sales as well. So I think that's going to do it for me today. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. I definitely appreciate your time. If you enjoyed this video at all, take 2 seconds and hit that like button down below. It's totally free and really helps me and the channel out a ton. And if you haven't yet, go ahead and click that subscribe button down below as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. You're the best, and I'll catch you on the next one.